to National Ensign. We are hanging out on the lovely red couch with Eric Perrion and family.
What's up? How's it going?
It's going. Thank you guys so much for being here. Who do we have on the couch right now? Who are your friends?
These are my best buds. This is Miss Emily Boyle and Mike Roynesdahl.
So you guys, how long have you guys done this band together?
This has been about a year.
Where are you guys from? What brought you to Nashville? I assume it's music.
I grew up in Northern New Jersey, and music really was not a part. Creating music wasn't a part of my life until I was about 21.
Okay.
Yeah, it kind of happened like literally overnight. Because I got made fun of for singing when I was younger. So I kind of just suppressed that part of me.
And you like built your skill behind closed doors and you're like, what up, world?
You know, like shout out to one of my best friends, Jeff Gogates. Because like when we would hang out, we would sing together. But it would be like, you know, like low key, like just like it was like our bonding thing. Like, we would just sing. We would, you know, sing a lot of Linkin Park, System of a Down. Yeah. And like that was our thing. But then at college at Rutgers, my senior year, I'm at the gym and I'm going to the bathroom and I'm singing This Love by Maroon 5. And this dude hears me, but I'm in the stall and I open the door when I'm finished and he's just like this, like by the sink. And he's like,
and you're like, I don't have any soap. There's a twinkle in his eye. I don't know what's happening.
Wow. That took a turn right there. No.
You knew it was going to go there. You just knew.
Long story short, he was a recording artist when he was younger. So he was like, so you sing. So we knew each other just from like at the gym, like just loosely knowing each other. And then I played a show with him and that was it. Like I knew what I needed to do the rest of my life.
Yeah. So 21 is about the time that you were like, that was the bathroom situation.
The bathroom point, moment.
The fork in the road.
I flushed the rest of my life down the drain.
Oh, whoa, good.
Moved on.
Clever.
That's right.
Clever.
Yeah, see, we did
I like what you did there.
Yeah. Flash forward a bunch of years because I sucked when I started. I didn't know anything. I didn't play an instrument. Yeah. I've never written a song before.
Yeah.
So like I was so green, I didn't know anything. So I got my chops up a little bit in Jersey. And then I moved down to Nashville about 3 years ago. My housing situation fell apart.
You lived in a car for a little bit.
I lived in a car
for a while. That's an artist grind, man.
Yeah, I didn't tell my family for a while because it was like partly embarrassment, but also I didn't want my mom to like freak out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's an Italian mother. It would have been a bad scene, right? So I just kept that to myself. But I'm so thankful for it.
Yeah.
It is unbelievable.
Class, I want to, and I may get this wrong, but class 7, Kid Politic calls it the suck.
But every band who's ever made it has gone through the hustle really hard.
Mm-hmm.
And so we call that portion of town the suck.
It's what humbles you. It's what drives you on a completely different level. And I think that, you know, you have to go through some form of the suck at some point of your artistry.
So at least you
got that out of the way.
totally got that out of the way.
So
still suck a little bit.
How was it? Like, how was your like living? Do you have a living room inside
your
car? And how was it like when you brought ladies over?
The back left seat was the most popular spot. Something about the cushion there. It wasn't too worn in yet.
There you go.
It was amazing though, because I played out on the street with this little battery powered amp at 3rd and Broadway. Yeah, just my acoustic. And Matt Carter from True Villains.
Yay!
Class 8. He was one of the first people. He came over.
He was such a good dude.
So we linked up like right away. And it was so cool. And then tie more of True Villains into us. Bo, their frontman, moved here with Mike.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Which is why Mike worked for Fed Up in True Villains' music video, Electric Blue.
I had a good mustache.
I was the chick coming out of the box with all the beer cans. Yep. That was me. So with you living in your car and consuming ungodly amounts of food, how did that work out?
Oh, so you know about my food consumption.
I do.
On a serious note, I suffer from depression, which I'm sure a lot of people do. I eat a lot of food, like
comfort,
incredible amounts of food. And you know, a lot of people are like, oh, I do too. I do that. And I'm sure a lot of people do, but it's like, I don't know. I go into like a haze, like a trance, and I will eat.
Like you black out?
Yeah. One time I like added up everything I ate and I was like, I just ate like 6,500 calories of food. It was like one of those moments. But like, then I realized that it was something I do all the time.
Yeah. So you guys give us something weird, random about yourselves that is also entertaining that we can entertain our viewers with. Nobody really knows.
All right. So in order to like give them the full picture, I need to introduce who Emily is and like how she came to
We love picture. You, Emily.
Emily is the shit.
Emily so is the shit.
Emily and I met.
She was giving you guys shit, which made me love her even more in the B-roll side of this.
Outside so people Emily, probably think
I love you already.
Other.
So
yeah, but that's how, you know, that's how our dynamic is. We make fun of each other.
That's great.
You know, more than we compliment each other. But you know, those moments where we do compliment each other, it means so much. Yeah. I know that. So Emily and I met on American Idol. She was with her mom at the time.
Yeah.
We hit it off just like talking and like, you notice my accent, the talking.
Talking.
That's right. Her mother. Oh man.
I wish
we could do a soundbite of her mother, Kathy. Love
you.
You
guys are gonna have to send us one. So
it's fantastic.
Yeah.
We'll
put it in.
Yeah. So we hit it off. We kept in touch through the years.
Yeah.
And now we're all here. She goes to Belmont. She's studying music industry, all that fun stuff. Incredible singer, obviously.
Yay.
So us three, Mike coming from Minnesota. Emily and I
Minnesota.
We like to make fun of his accent. So that kind of turned into us developing these pseudo personalities.
Let's hear it.
So Emily is
Miriam.
You are
Olaf.
And I'm Micah. So, you know, don't you know? So it's important that we talk in that accent once in a while to.
Can you guys hit us with it for a second? Can you give it like script something? Can you guys off the dome? Kind of improv some shit right now for us?
Well, I'll tell you something about Eric.
Oh, no.
This is not so much weird, but this man is very hairy.
He's Italian. I guess it makes sense.
Oh, man.
Very, very Italian. And, well, his shoulders have more hair than my downstairs.
So
we have to wax him on the regular.
At your neckline. Come on. Yeah.
Open it up a little.
You know, you gotta.
If I could beat the shit out of you, I would.
You gotta open it up a little.
All right. You get a little,
one day you're gonna.
There you go.
There you go. That's it, guys. Not till sometime.
If I could just put that on my face, I'd have a real beard.
You guys make my face hurt right now, so we're gonna move it to a more serious note.
Okay.
So our last segment is WHYLD. It's What Have You Learned, Dude? And you guys obviously have been in and out of the music industry in a lot of different facets. So tell us like your most important learning lesson that you can give to some up and comers that you've learned along the way.
Oh, for sure. I think the biggest one for me is stay with it. You know, they say perseverance and sometimes that gets hammered in a little too much, but that's because it's true.
Yeah.
You know, instant success, it does happen for some people. So I guess, you know, you think about that sometimes because, you know, social media, it's so easy to see the successes of people and how fast it happens. And yeah, it does happen, but it's the vast minority.
Yeah.
For the rest of us, stay with it.
It's a grind.
Persevere. Keep getting better at what you do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and of course, believing in yourself the whole way.
Yeah.
Surround yourself with people that really care about you, that believe in what you're doing,
yeah.
that are good people. But stay with it because that's what every industry person has told me. You know, it's the same thing around the world.
It is. Yeah. Richard Branson, you know, the guy that serial entrepreneur, Virgin, he owns everything. But his number one piece of advice to entrepreneurs, which artists travel the exact same road as an entrepreneur, but he said persistence is key.
Yeah.
And so just there are going to be so many people that give up, but the ones that don't are the ones left standing, are the ones that get, you know, they get the Grammy, they get the, you know, the long-term success. And it's not to say that success is a Grammy. Success could just mean making a healthy average income to be able to go and do what you love to do for the rest of your life. So success can look a bunch of different ways.
Yeah.
You know? So yay. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
For being here. Eric Perrion and company. Thank you guys so much for being here. We love these guys. We're going to sync them up on all things social media and you guys can stalk them. Shout out to the Sound Shelter. Get on his website and buy his shirt. We love you guys. We're out.
Ooh,
yeah.